Divine Truth Assistance Group. Group assistance sessions putting principles of divine truth into action. This recording is from the Understanding God's Loving Laws group and is part of an Education in Love series. In the welcome and housekeeping presentation, Mary welcomes the participants to the assistance group and outlines the general plan for the program, along with providing some general principles for participants to follow. Recorded on the 4th of November, 2016, in Noosaville, Queensland, Australia.
Wow, the anticipation in the air, hey? Or fear, perhaps. We're not that scary, are we?
Not yet. It's good to see you guys.
Lovely to see you all.
How many months? For many of you, it's 4, isn't it? For some of you, it's years. For some of you, we've never seen you before, and welcome.
Yeah. Welcome. Yeah.
How many from overseas? Just put up your hands. Quite a number. Yep. So we've got, who's represented? We've got Sweden represented.
Couple from Sweden.
USA represented.
Yeah.
Where else we got? Canada.
Canada. Slovenia.
Slovenia.
Barbados.
Barbados. Mexico. Yeah. There you go.
Very nice.
Yep. Thanks for making the effort to come. I'm sure you'll enjoy yourself. Maybe. We'll do our very, very best to make it as hard as, no, as nice as possible for you. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're looking forward to this program, actually. I think you'll find the program very inspirational. You've all managed to have a look at your outlines so you can see the subject matter. How many of you thought we were going to talk about a law of attraction and a law of cause and effect? And how many of you thought that before you got the outlines? Yeah, and then when you get the outlines, you go, what's this about?
Did you think, is this for the right group? What are they on about?
Yeah, and as you went through the outlines, you would have seen that why we've done it the way we have. Yeah. Anyway, all I'm going to leave you in Mary's capable hands for 40 minutes or so, and then I'll get up and browbeat you for another 40. And we hope to be out by about 8 this evening so we can get an early enough night to start tomorrow.
Yeah.
But we just wanted to come both up and welcome you all here.
And we'd like to say a welcome
to those who are going to be watching us via video and who are not here as well. Yeah. Would you like to say hello to them?
Yeah.
Yeah, let's. Yeah. At the moment, that's about 4,500 people. So you just said hello to around 4,500 people. Anyway, it's lovely to see you all here, and I'll bow out. And leave you in Mary's capable hands.
All right. Well, welcome. As we've just said, as Jesus has just said to you guys, this is the start of our third group in the Education in Love series. And as you all should know by now, it's all about understanding God's loving laws. And it's been a real pleasure preparing this material for you guys. A lot of work's gone into it. Jesus and I have prepared all of the outlines that you've read, and we've, much like the previous one, written and rewritten and thought exactly how it's going to be most attainable for you guys to understand. So I hope that we've achieved something good there. I think that we have. I think that it's really amazing material. So let's get going, hey? All right. So it's our pleasure to welcome you and to meet some of you for the first time, as Jesus has just said. We're really happy to present the sessions to you. And Jesus and I will be presenting throughout the week. And our technical support team is Lena and Igor, as usual, Cornelius and Eloisa, and also Kelly is going to be helping us out on the cameras. Now, I want to talk to you guys very briefly. There's a lot for me to cover in this presentation. But very briefly about the choices that you have ahead of you for this week. You have the choice, you have the opportunity available to you to really engage with what we've prepared to meet each other, to love each other, and to really open your heart to receive some education in love, some of this stuff that will carry you not just from in this life but well beyond into your life in the spirit world. So, but they're all choices available to you. We can't make those things happen. You have the opportunity also to be quite humble and to implement these key principles that Jesus has taught you in the first two groups as you engage with this material. There's also something I think that's really special in front of you as an opportunity. And I just want to pause with you for a minute to consider this with you. There's a lot of truth that's known on the planet. We've all established it as truth. And a lot of you would have learnt it in your schooling system or in your professional training. There's a lot of things that have been established. Someone on earth has experimented. They've tried something. They've engaged a process of discovery and they've come upon truth. We agree on that, yeah? But it's very rare, isn't it, that we have the opportunity to learn that truth from the person who actually discovered it. Imagine learning the theory of relativity from Einstein. The passion and enthusiasm and the spirit of discovery that he had in order to establish that. Now, if you really consider it, this week you have the opportunity, it's very rare on earth, but to learn about this material from a person and even maybe persons who've discovered it for themselves. So I want to encourage you in to embrace that opportunity. It's pretty special, yeah. All right. Now to the slightly mundane, where I'll tell you, I want to whiz through the housekeeping. You've all seen your outlines, and many of you have been here before, so you know a lot of what goes on. But there is a bit of new stuff happening this time, so I'm just going to skip through a lot of what you should already be aware of and then spend a little bit of time on some of the things that have changed this group. Okay, so this whole program runs for 34 hours, depending on how well we go, sticking to our times. We're going to be focusing on God's loving laws, and we'll be doing that via 16 major principles. Now, these principles govern God's laws. There are more principles, and there is more that we could say about each principle. So don't think that this is definitive coverage of this topic, but it's what we could fit in the time we had available. Okay, you have 6 days of contact time. I don't think I need to tell you guys that. You've all seen your timetable. What is really important is that you are here before the start of each presentation. That's just an issue of love for everyone involved, including the presenters, the other participants. If you come late, it creates a disruption for everyone. You know there's a break day. You'll have homework on your break days. And your first session starts at 10:30 on the first day of each session, and then the second day of the session starts at 11. So there's 3 sessions in total, each of 2 days long. Okay. All right. Timing is very important. You're going to have toilet breaks pretty regularly, but this group, there is some patches where you have to go an hour and 20 without a loo break. Sorry about that, but we had so much to jam in. I'll warn you. I'll warn you as we start the stretch or the break before so you know to go. But aside from that, it's a minute 10 or even less. So hopefully you'll be all right. We're not going to wait to start presentations. In the last group, we had a lot of problems with people coming in late and delaying the program or interrupting the program. It's really important. You've got enough education in love so far, I think, to respect the time of everyone else involved. So please be on time. We're not going to wait for you. Music's going to be played just like it was played tonight to signal you to come back into the room to signal the end of the break. So by the time the music finishes, we need you guys sitting in your chairs ready to listen. Much like this evening was amazing. Okay. Toilet breaks are 10 minutes and lunch breaks are half an hour. All right. There's a little bit of general info just about eating The cafe out here has decided to discontinue their special vegan menu. I think there might be a few options there, vaguely vegan, but they're not catering to the vegan crowd anymore. And as a result, it's up to you guys where you eat and when you eat. There's some limited options of restaurants nearby in terms of vegan food, but there's plenty of supermarkets and fruit and vegetable shops. And if most of you are staying here at the venue, you've got a kitchen in your room anyway, and yeah, you can socialise that way. Yeah. Because the cafe is no longer doing the vegan menu, at previous groups we had Kate and Fabio doing a music program on your break days. We could sit and have a meal and hear some music, but we've discontinued that this group just because there's no vegan meals there. So, okay. Silly to have you sitting there not eating, listening to the music. It's not so good for you and also not so good for other people who might want to frequent the cafe. All right. Hard disk drive copying. A lot of you would probably know that we offer a free service to copy your hard drives with all of the material that we've ever created. If you have a hard drive with you, it needs to be at least, are we up to 2 terabytes now? Yep, 2 terabytes in size. And you need to label it with your name and the type of computer you have, so a Mac or a PC. And you can leave the disk that you want copied labelled correctly up on the back table from where you collected your name tags, so on the left as you come in the door. Jesus or myself will collect them, do the copying for you, and when it's done, you'll find them back on the opposite table, so on your right-hand side as you come into the room. Okay, any questions about that? Oh, cool. There is the way that we're copying the material onto the hard drives. There's a special way that it's done, and you can read more about it on the website. But basically, Jesus has created a system where you have the whole website that's offline and you can use it clickable just to access all of the links and all of the videos and documents via that offline website. But you just need to know how to access it, and it's all there on the website for you to have a look at under the hard disk drive copying section. Okay. All right, there's a few people here with families, kids and stuff. Just to reiterate, as I think you probably know by now, kids are your own responsibility. There's lots of pools and various things around this venue that can be dangerous to kids. So we need you to take responsibility for them. There's no child minding service unless you've personally arranged that. Yeah. And if your kids are noisy, obviously, please take them outside so that they don't interrupt what we're up to. We mean you. All right. Just some other general things. Is anyone sharing accommodation with someone they haven't met before? Yeah, a few of you. Hopefully you're going to be best of buddies by the end of the group. If not, I hope that you've taken the opportunity to practice the principles of love with each other, love and truth, and being humble to your own stuff, using a lot of the principles that Jesus is going to talk to you about during the week. You'll have lots of good fodder for practicing if you're sharing accommodation. Okay. The other thing is that the venue has said that anyone who's attending the groups can use the facilities. So I know not all of you are staying on site. And even if you're staying off-site in a camping ground or whatever, if you'd like to come and use the pool during or any of the pools, there's a few pools and a tennis court and various other things, they're all available to you if you're a guest or a participant here. So that's lovely, isn't it? Yeah. And that also means if you want to socialise with each other on your day off, even if you're not staying on-site, you can arrange that and catch up by the pool or whatever. So that's lovely, yeah. Okay. All right. So I want to talk to you guys about just some issues of love now. There's lots to cover again, but hopefully a lot of these are becoming quite obvious to you. The more that we talk to you guys about this stuff and the more that we share about what it means to be loving. It's loving to keep your room clean and tidy while you're here staying and to take care, just general care of the cleanliness of your environment, and that includes here in the conference room. If you're staying on site, you likely know that you don't have servicing in your room. No one comes and changes your linen and so forth during your stay, but you can arrange that privately if you want to with them. Please
be courteous to the staff and the other people
here. There's lots of people about, and I hope that you'll observe that. All right. Very importantly, we're recording everything here that's going on in the room. And if you have been observant, you'll have seen 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 cameras in the room. And these cameras are all recording live, and there's a live feed from each one going to Igor, and he's switching between them to create a single output while we're speaking. So this means that if you happen to stand up in front of a camera or bump a camera, it makes life fairly difficult for Igor, for the camera operator, and it creates quite a bit of flow-on effect. So this is something that you're going to learn this week. Every time we disregard a principle of love, there is a lot of rippling effects out to other things. And that's a prime example. So if you can please be aware that the recording is happening. Please don't hide when you have the microphone and someone's trying to film you while you're speaking. By being in this room, you've basically agreed to be filmed. And if you're not happy to be filmed, then you need to go now, because you've basically said that you're happy to be filmed by sitting here. So if you then try and hide from the camera, you're actually being quite sort of sneaky and a bit devious, really, because you're almost going, well, you are, you're going back on your word, on your contract, and that is a sin. So please don't hide from the camera, and I'll say more about that later on. Microphone use. Now, there's a bit to say about microphones, and this is important because I know a number of you haven't been here before. So while you're in the room, there's microphones being used for questions and answers. It's important, if you are given the microphone to ask a question, that you hold it correctly. That means that you hold it up to your face, just below your chin, sort of at this angle, so that the microphone can pick up your voice. Can everyone see that? Yep. So you don't want it up here, down there, over there, talking, pointing. You know, be aware, be spatially aware. You know, I have some challenges with spatial awareness, I know, but it's it's pretty basic kind of thing. And many of you have heard about this from us for many years. And that's where things start to get serious. I'll talk about that later on. Okay, but basically everyone can see how you use the mic. And if you are sitting in any row after the third row, so basically from where Jesus is sitting back, that row and back, pretty much level with Lena and back, you need to stand when asking your question. So when you receive the microphone, Jesus will indicate it's time for your question. You need to stand up and remain standing up while the interaction is happening with him, or with me for that matter. Okay, sound all right? Now, we also need microphone runners while you're in the room. So this means people who take the microphones to the people who are going to ask the questions. Now, there's 2 seats allocated for the microphone runners. If you towards the back of the room, they're coloured chairs, and they're always vacant, ready for the microphone runner to sit in, because it's on rotation. And what we've developed over the last couple of groups is that pretty much everyone in the audience has a turn at serving the other members of the group in this way and being a microphone runner. So unless you have some kind of physical issue where you can't get up and move around the room freely, then you're going to have a turn at doing this. Sound all right? Yep. Basically, what I've decided is Igor has an alphabeticized list of all of your names. And so for each session, so for example, tonight, Alan is our first Alan, and it was going to be the other Alan who's not arrived. So who's next on my list, Igor? Alicia, yeah. So if Alicia, you go back. So if you sit on that side and Alan back there. Thank you, guys. So basically, for every session we have, there's a new set of microphone runners. So for every, I shouldn't say session, for every period we have between breaks. So tonight there's one, and so there's one lot of mic runners. Then tomorrow, up until the first break, there'll be another lot. At the break, you switch. So at the break, you take your microphones back to Igor, and Igor will contact the next persons on the list to be the runners. Is that clear? Yep. Okay. When you're the microphone runner, your job is to not move the microphone until Jesus or I indicate who's next to have the microphone. So some people are going to have their hands up. You don't just go to them thinking that we're going to allocate time to them. You wait till we say, okay, next on the mic is Ivana and Felix, and then you move and give the mics to them. Is that all right? Cool. Then you hang out nearby till, so you're ready to take it quickly back off the person who's had the microphone, and then you can return back to your temporary seat and wait for the next question. Is that all right? Okay. Cool. All right. Okie doke.
Hey, darling.
Yes.
Can I just mention for those runners, because everyone's going to be a runner.
Yes.
Please take a lot of care when you go in front of the cameras. Because yeah. Just when the two got up just now, they went in front of a camera. So it's easy to forget that the cameras are there. If you can just remember the cameras and try to stay out of the way of the cameras, that'd be good.
All right. Ivana?
I was just wondering, so when we are the mic runners, do we just stop maybe at the camera, like to hand it to like someone in the front row?
Can crouch.
Yep.
Yeah.
Okay.
Cool. You just need to steer clear of the cameras.
Yeah, sure.
But you don't want to get into this situation where you're passing, you've got some big chain of passing the microphone to other people.
Yeah. Cool.
The other thing to take care of for all of you is the way that you're holding the microphone. If I just grab that one back off you, Alan. When you're the mic runner, this mic is on all of the time. So if you're sitting there having a conversation with the person next to you, everyone's going to hear it. And if you're sitting there bashing it on your leg, everyone's going to hear it. And let alone, it's a very expensive piece of equipment. So you want to take care of it, okay? So hold it here. Don't hold it up here. Don't hold it down here. Hold it centrally and take good care of this precious piece of equipment. Okay, all right. All right. I'm just going to fly through because I want to really talk to you guys about some serious things at the end. So loving your presenters, we're talking for a long time each day, so there's not time during the week to have personal interactions with you guys or personal questions. Please respect the space, especially of Jesus. He's speaking an immense amount of time. He's not there to field your questions in the break, before we start or after. When we finish for the day, please clear the room promptly. Okay. And the question time in this group is really to ask about the material that's covered, not your personal situation. So this group, there are no personal feedback sessions. In previous groups, we've had that available to you. This is not the group for that. This is all about understanding the principles governing law. Okay. Loving each other. Please make sure that you practice principles of love with each other and with the volunteers who are serving you. People who don't demonstrate love towards our volunteers will be asked to leave. These guys are giving their time, their effort for free to provide a beautiful gift to you all. And if we find that you're unloving to any of them, we will ask you to leave. So that's your warning about that. Okay. Please be on time for the presentations. Please don't miss any of the presentations. So much care and effort has gone into every part of what we're going to deliver to you this week. Not only the material, but the technological aspects, everything involved. And when you haven't prepared for the sessions, when you miss a session, when you haven't read your outlines, you're basically disrespecting the gift that is being offered to you. And we will take that very seriously as well this time. Okay. Ignoring our requests, such as the ones that I've just been making to you for the last 20 minutes, is a very serious issue. And it is an ongoing issue that Jesus and I have decided very clearly that is not going to continue. So we feel that for the majority of you, we have covered a lot of this material time and again, and yet there is still issues where you aren't on time, you don't hold the microphone correctly, and it's not our job to support you in your sin. Basically, if we let these things go on and go on and go on, we're basically saying it's okay for you to ignore our requests. It's okay for you to just do whatever you want. And that's really supporting you in a sinful position. And we're not going to do that anymore. Okay. As I've said, we're going to be addressing everything immediately this time. So be prepared, guys. This is where you have the opportunity to receive some pretty direct feedback, but we hope that you're already self-reflective enough that we don't have to address very much. We'll see how we go, hey? All right. Just finally on this housekeeping stuff, has everyone got a copy of their outlines?
Yeah.
Yep. Anyone not have a copy of their outlines? Ivana, Banana and Chris, you guys, you're already demonstrating a lack of respect for the gift. If it's a digital copy, that's fine. That's fine. Yeah, yeah. But just you need to, this is every day you need to be reading your outlines before you come. And there's actually a new procedure for asking questions, which means that you need to actually have written down your questions before you actually receive a microphone and speak your question. So this is where you, before you arrive at the session each day, you have the opportunity to write down questions. It's still fine to have questions come to you while you're listening to Jesus present all of this, but you need to have it already written down before you ask it in the group. There's a lot of good and loving reasons for that, but I don't have time to go into them right now. I will tell you about this other way that you can ask a question. At the back of a room, you're going to find two folders, and in each folder, there's duplicated, it's the same stuff in each folder, but there's a sheet for each presentation that Jesus will give. So tomorrow morning, he starts with fundamental facts, after that, love principles, truth principles, and the name of the talk is written at the top and the bottom of each page. If you already have questions pertaining to any of those talks, you have the opportunity now or at any time during the group to write your name and the question next to it. What's going to happen is in the break preceding the Q&A about each of these presentations, Jesus will have the opportunity to see the sheet. If he sees a question that he really likes, he might not go to the audience for new questions, spontaneous questions. He might say, okay, Christine had a good question, we're going to her. And Christine, you'll have written it here and also in your notebook so that when he goes to you, you can read it from your notebook and he'll answer the question. Does that make sense? It also goes that after the presentation, if you had a burning question or a number of burning questions that weren't able to be answered in the Q&A, you have the opportunity to write them down and we can cover them in our studio sessions. Okay. Does that make sense? Yeah. Yvonne? Alan? Oh, now, Alicia, this is a great example.
Please, mic runners, don't
cross the aisle. So if you're allocated to that side, stay on that side and vice versa. That's because Eagle's monitoring sound. So that's a great thing to demonstrate now.
Mary, just about the questions. We can ask questions during the content or during the presentation. And then we can also ask questions in the Q&A. Is there a difference in those types of questions?
Yes, and I'm about to talk a little bit about that. Yeah. Okay. Just quickly on the water, there's water in this room. For you guys, many of you have water bottles. You can fill up your water bottle during the day while you're here, fresh, lovely water. That's our gift to you guys. However, this water is not for you to fill up your water bottles and take back to your room. It's your responsibility to have your own water in your room and so on. Make sense? Yeah. Okay. Now, on to the types of questions. So, Yvonne, you asked about, is there a difference between the two? In general, what the type of questions that we want to hear, this group, are all about the material that's being presented. So you will have seen in your outline already, we've given you some examples of the types of questions you might be asking. So things like, so Jesus, when you explained that thing, were you saying this? Did you mean that? I'm trying to understand a principle. So why is such and such important to this principle? So you're trying to define and clarify everything that he's teaching. Does that make sense? Yeah. Now, if you think about it, if you really have a seeking heart towards this material, that's the type of question you phrase anyway. What we've found over time, though, is you guys are very prone to be in addiction. Remember these little cards that we created for you? That was our fun way of saying, this is not a real question. It's actually you wanting to tell a story or you wanting to, you know, just get some attention from daddy up the front, you know, or whatever it was. So this group, we are going to be much hotter on that entire thing. So we want your questions to be about understanding the content. Something we want you to grasp is that if you know a principle, you can apply it to many different areas of your life. And I think I mentioned that last time. If you just ask specific things about your personal life, well, maybe you get a little bit of insight into one situation in your life, but you still feel pretty clueless about how it all applies to everything else. So this is why these kind of questions, and that goes especially, Yvonne, in the questions that you ask during the presentations. But you'll notice the presentations and the Q&As are quite short and quite compact, this group, and Jesus might just go off script. He might just say, hey, you guys are floundering, we are skipping this outline and I'm going somewhere else entirely, so be prepared for that. He's always, as you know, responsive to where you're at. So he might end up amalgamating things, but you'll still have your basic timetable. But if you can, in these sessions where he's teaching you a principle, you want to learn about the principle. And if you ask questions that are not pertaining to learning about the principle, you're not going to get an answer. Is that clear? Yeah. Okay. All right. Now, as I've said, there's a lot of attitudes currently in the audiences that we're wanting to address more directly. And there are a lot of addiction, a lot of desire to sin, to remain very comfortable in your sin. And we're going to shake that up with you a lot this week. So I just chose a few from your outline. You would have seen we prepared a table of unloving behaviour and loving behaviour. I just chose a few that I want to go through with you guys because I chose the ones that I thought were really chronic. All right. So this one about preparation. What I notice is a lot of you come, you've hardly even looked at the outlines, you've hardly even really considered what it's all about. It's a free event. I'm just going to rock up. And these guys, they're lovely, and I'll just listen, and sometimes I just chuck in a question that really demonstrates that I didn't read anything in any of the outlines, and I give myself away. And this is really unloving. It is really unloving, guys. As I mentioned, there's a lot of work that goes in. If you could see the amount of work that Jesus puts in to these groups, this is such a high standard of presentation in the way that it's designed and developed and the way that it's presented and produced. It is really of a high caliber. There's no question. And what I notice is that there's still a lot of unloving attitudes surrounding it because it is a free event. And that says something about some of the emotions within you guys surrounding how you value things. and how you disregard or devalue other things just because they're free. And so this is really unloving, and it is something that I feel very strongly about. When you rely on the presenters to guide you through everything, to so many things I see you guys relying on Jesus for, because you know he's got it, you know he can feel it, you know he's onto it, and you know that he loves truth, and so he's going to share it all with you. But you're very often thinking selfishly and not about everyone else who's going to hear this presentation after you, and what's the real purpose of us being here, and what do I need to do inside of myself to get my heart ready and open to hear what's going on. And we do a lot in preparation to help you get ready to be open, if you think about it. So it's quite unloving not to do any prep. The loving thing that you have the opportunity to do from now is to read your outlines every morning before you get to the room. Have a think about what's this all about? What's the intention today? What do I feel questioning about? And if you can do that each morning, you'll be in a much better space and be demonstrating a lot more love. I've mentioned preparing your questions in advance and having this seeking attitude. Okay, sound all right?
All right.
The next one is about making personal statements. Now, a lot of you have this desire just to share me with everyone here just because I would like to just share. I just realized something. Or I had this situation once, is exactly like what you were talking about. And, you know, I've just realized that what you said probably applies to me. How many of you have done that kind of thing? I need the microphone just to say that. Yeah, a lot of you nodding there. It's actually really unloving, guys. You're actually imposing yourself on all of these other people who haven't requested to hear from you, and you're doing it in an addiction. It's not the same as seeking more information or seeking to understand. So we're going to be pretty hot on that this time. As I said, you're forcing other people to actually hear you. Yeah. The loving thing to do is to be succinct, define your questions, know what you want to know, and let your personal story just be for you and those in a personal relationship with you. There's always a good question there's often a good question that you can ask, but when you just want to share your experience with others, this is where you're getting into the situation of sinning. And it's very addictive and selfish. Okay. So we've talked about preparation. We've talked about making personal statements. Let's talk about questions. So a lot of you are not defining your questions. And this is like, I watch this happen a lot, especially with Jesus. A lot of you have a half-formed thought in your head and you put up your hand and go, Jesus, what about, and you hardly get even a question out. You maybe say two or three words that are on the topic. And what I notice happens is Jesus can feel you. He knows what you're going to ask. He knows what you want to know. And what's happened for a long time is that he's then gone, oh, you want to ask this thing. So he states your question for you and then he answers it for you. Now, the problem is with this, the only thing it gives you faith in is his ability to feel your emotions, doesn't it? You go, wow, he can really feel me. And I've got proof of that now because he can even feel me when I just say three incoherent words that are supposed to be a question. But what it doesn't do for you is develop in you personal responsibility. It doesn't help you even in your personal reflection. And it is actually quite unloving for everyone else in the room who's just like, what? What's going on? I don't even know. He's answering a question that I didn't even hear because he knows the question. So can you see that it's quite unloving to keep going in this way? And this is why we're saying now everything you ask has to be written down. Okay. Saying whatever pops into your head, it wastes a lot of time. And also what I've noticed is a lot of you start to get a bit emotionally confronted by what's being presented, don't you? And then what happens, you go, oh, I want to change the subject, or you go a bit out of your body, or you go away from yourself a bit, and then you're very open to spirits who would love to take it all off topic, or you just yourself, you'd like to take it off topic, and so you ask a question that is very, very, very vaguely related to what is being discussed. And sometimes you get away with going off down the garden path, but it really depletes the quality of the overall presentation. Now, last time Jesus was a lot more hot on that with you guys, but be prepared this time even more, okay? The loving attitude is to prepare your questions, as I've mentioned, and make sure you're clear, okay? All right, answers. Now, this one is also really important. What I notice a lot of you doing is that you do not listen to the answer. You also don't have any concept of how thorough Jesus is being in answering your question. A lot of you put up your hand, ask a question, already think you kind of know the answer anyway and you really just want a bit of reassurance, or he starts to explain something, giving you a broad context, preparing you to give you a very specific answer to the particular question that you've raised. Do you know what I mean by that? He's giving you the background information. And a lot of you feel like, I already know all this, and so you start cutting him off, not realizing that the reason he's giving you this broad context is because he can feel you already don't grasp that bit, and that's why you don't understand the more specific question. Or you just feel like, no, I just want him to talk about my specific thing. And you cut him off, or you argue with him. Or in fact, you do it with me as well. I shouldn't just be speaking about Jesus, because many of you ladies like to do this thing where you just speak over the top of me and just agree, yes, 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 Mary, yes, yes, before I've even told you the answer, which is another sort of passive-aggressive way of shutting the person down. So all of these things are very unloving. Changing the subject, you're not being humble, not listening. And there's a lot of disagreement voiced by you guys where you're actually asking someone a question and then you're saying, no, you're getting it wrong. Can you see that it's not loving to ask a question of someone if you're going to argue with them? Especially someone who's giving you their time for free. Okay. The loving thing is to not argue, to not waste other people's time. And don't be forceful in taking other people's time. Okay. All right. Use of the microphone. Again, we've covered a lot of this. It's very important to use a microphone correctly. And it's an issue not just of consideration of the actual microphone use, but of how much we have actually spoken to you guys about this, how much training you have in it, and how much you're still wanting to not observe the rules of your environment, the laws, if you like, of your environment, which is a sin. And it's a purposeful sin. So this probably leads me to the decisions that Jesus and I have made. So from now on any of these issues that I've raised with you this evening, if we find that you're out of harmony with our requests, then we will address it immediately with you. If we find that you're not holding the microphone correctly, then we're not even going to speak with you about it. We're just going to say, up, move on. Who is the next person? We feel we've given you enough warnings about all of this. And I feel also that it takes away from the overall presentation. When I'm watching it back on video, if I have to hear 5 times in every Q&A, could you please hold the microphone closer to your mouth? I can't hear what you're saying. Could you please define your question? You're in a story now. Jesus actually timed, he has to listen to all of the Q&A sessions again back after each of our talks. And after the last one, he did a little experiment and he timed how much time was wasted in one Q&A session, just in people in their addictions, in their stories, before they even got to the question, correcting people about the microphone use or prompting microphone runners or asking people to stand up. Was a lot of time. It was over 10 minutes in the whole session, wasn't it, babe? So over 10 minutes out of 50 was wasted. That's time that could have been spent discussing truth. And if you notice in your timetables for this session, some of our Q&A sessions don't even last that long, like they're 15 minutes long. If we spend 5 or 10 minutes of it in correction, we won't even get to answer one question. So this is really important, this group, you guys. Yeah. Okay. And that's also why we're not going to spend any more time correcting. We're just going to move on. As I've said, we won't be explaining ourselves. This is the explanation here. This is your warning here. And while I feel like I'm, you know, being very firm with you, it is something that we feel very strongly about. And we feel like you're all grown-ups. One of the major themes of this group, as you're going to learn, is about taking personal responsibility, self-responsibility. And this is an opportunity to practice that. And if you're not willing to practice that, you're going to learn there's a lot of limitations in terms of your experience of God's universe. Conversely, if you are willing to be self-responsible, there's many, many opportunities and beautiful things that open up for you as well in God's universe. So this is where it's real. And something that my guides kept saying to me in the last couple of days was, it's fine to get up and talk to you about all of these principles, but unless I'm willing to enact these principles with you, I'm not really teaching you. So I feel really strongly about that, this group. And I know that Jesus is very certain about that in this group. So you'll see how we go. We'll see how you go. Okay. Yeah, with the answering of the questions, we're only taking questions that are on topic and only about things that have already been covered. Do you know what I mean by that? That means Jesus already has to have spoken about it and you're asking about what he's presented, rather than trying to get ahead of where we're at and pull him down a road or pull me in a different direction, because you're going to need to be patient to allow us to get through what needs to be gotten through. A lot of you want to jump ahead because you get a bit afraid. You go, oh, well, does that mean? Oh, hang on. And that's just you acting in your fear or to avoid your fear. Okay. All right. Aside from all that, just please relax. We honestly, I need to say all of that stuff to you very firmly. We do feel firmly about it. But we also see that this is a great opportunity to just enjoy yourselves. This is a beautiful truth that we're going to be discussing, and that's my opinion anyway. And I feel like this week can be so inspiring in your relationship with God. We're teaching you about God's nature and personality in everything that's imbued in everything that he's created. And so, you know, please relax, enjoy yourself. Be yourself. Remember last group we talked a lot about being yourself, and this is another opportunity to practice that, okay? And please participate and write your questions at the beginning of the day. Sound all right? Does anyone have any questions? I have 1 minute, literally. Deirdre? Yeah, if you leave your hand up till the mic runner gets to you, that's good.
Sorry. I've already got some questions prepared, so I'll write them up, but Jesus might not even get to that topic, but that doesn't matter as long as I write them beforehand.
If you write them beforehand, there's a better chance, if they're good quality questions, that they'll get an answer. And even if he doesn't get to them or we go on in a different direction, they'll still be recorded for the discussions and the Q&A sessions that Jesus and I have in private in the studio. We're already really excited about recording some additional sessions about this material together, because we both really love it and we know that the time is limited in this week. So as long as they're on topic, good questions, Deirdre, there's a good chance they'll be answered either here or later on.
Okay, thank you. Yeah.
Felix?
I noticed in each of the sections, there's topics of the like human versus God's law and authority.
Yes.
Are they in with the rest, with the principles material, just because of time constraints, or was there something else that I'm missing?
You mean that we've got a human law comparison, a human law hangover within the timetable and the law-related attitudes and emotions? No, it's quite – we've placed them within the program in quite a specific way. Oh. So you're going to be learning about the principles and then contrasting that with some of your own personal experiences of law on earth, because the two, as you can imagine, as you're hopefully already opening up to the idea, that the experiences of humans' law really affects how we deal with God and how we feel about God's laws. So it's quite purposeful the way they are in the program. And there are sheets in your question. You can ask questions about those as well. On this, there's a corresponding sheet for each of those sessions as well.
Okay.
Anyway, Jesus is going to introduce you now more fully to the actual course material that we're going to be looking at in the next few days. So welcome, Darlin.
Thanks, mate.